Hello everyone. So in our today's video, we are going to start with the next point from the topic reproduction in lower and higher animals. The next point is the lactation. So as you have seen in previous video, the oxytocin is released, and this oxytocin is responsible for which induces the labor, initiate the labor in a female, and so the easy pasturation can happen. Okay. So this oxytocin is also responsible for milk ejection. As you have studied in previous, when we have studied the structure of mammary gland, during that, recall the previous video, in that we have studied that the hormone which is responsible for milk synthesis. There are two hormones. One is for milk synthesis. Okay, it's named as a prolactin. Prolactin. Okay, milk synthesis. And another one is milk ejection wala hormone. Okay, it's named as a oxytocin. So these two hormones, one is secreted by anterior pituitary. This prolactin is synthesized by anterior pituitary. And this is synthesized by the posterior pituitary. Okay, these are the two hormones. Mind this, the from where they are synthesized. Okay, can be asked for CT or NEET. Okay, so related with the pituitary, if you have studied in nervous control, we have a structure of this pituitary gland. Then we will see in detail. So this portion of a pituitary, this pituitary is a very small gland present in a, this is a master endocrine gland present in a brain below to the hypothalamus. So this part is called as a anterior pituitary, or it is also called as adenohypophysis, and this portion is called as a posterior pituitary. Posterior pituitary. Okay. So this anterior pituitary secretes the hormone named as a prolactin. Prolactin. And the posterior pituitary secretes the hormone named as a oxytocin. Okay. As you know, this prolactin is synthesized, start to form synthesis. Okay. When the female is in gestation period. When female consume, during that the prolactin synthesis starts, and it increases when the parturition happens. Okay, so milk synthesis starts when that female is conceiving. Okay, when she conceiving, during that it brings out the development of the breast and enlargement of breast as the maximum consumption of especially the fatty tissues. Okay. That happens during gestation, and especially the breast is a modified, yes, it's a modified sweat gland. So related with the breast, it is located in our chest region. It is also called as a breast. The mammary gland is also called as a breast. Okay, we have studied this structure. Here is the darkened region around the nipple. This erected portion is called as a nipple, and this darkened portion is called as a areola. Okay, and this nipple having opening of lactiferous ducts, 15 to 20 lactiferous ducts get open into nipple region. Into this region, the nipple get open. In a nipple, the lactiferous ducts get open, right? By the sucking action, when the mother receives the sucking action, during that, the excess secretion of prolactin occurs, and this prolactin starts secreting milk, okay? So it having lactiferous ducts, then the enlarged region, here is the enlargement, then again, it is divided into fine branches. fine prime branches, and these branches are goes into the this portion. Bunch like structure. So these are called as alveolus, mammary alveolus. These are the mammary alveolus, and this is the lobe. This is the lobe which contains alveolus, and these alveolus are responsible for synthesis of the milk. Especially it contains the mammary alveolus, mammary lobe. This is the mammary lobe. This mammary lobe is surrounded by, it is surrounded by adipose tissues. These are the adipose tissues. As you know, the adipose tissues having fat cell or adipocytes. That means there is a deposition of fat, right? Then it contains a mammary alveolus. Why I'm naming it as a mammary alveolus? Because alveoli are also the name given into the lungs. Basic structural unit of the lung is a alveoli. And here are the also the small structure which are present in a breast called as a mammary alveolus. Don't confuse between pulmonary alveolus and a mammary alveolus. The name is same, but the function is different, right? Then the next one, having an mammary duct. This is the mammary duct. Then enlarged region is named as a swollen region is called as the ampulla. And then this ampulla continue into this duct is called as a lactiferous duct. So this is all related with the structure of mammary gland. There are so many mammary lobes, and each lobe contains many these alveolus, mammary alveolus. From the mammary alveolus, small ducts are arising called as a mammary ducts. These ducts opens into the this swollen region called as ampulla, and this ampulla then opens into a common duct called as a lactiferous duct. And these ducts are 15 to 20 in numbers. And this opens into the nipple region. So the mammary gland, it is a modified sweat gland. It's a modified sweat gland. Can be asked for NEET. Our mammary glands are modified sweat glands. Why? The nipple is surrounded by areola. A darkened region. To this darkened region here, especially if this is the nipple, which is surrounded by this darkened region called as the areola. This areola having a openings, small openings, and these are of sebaceous gland. As we have studied that, and this is the projection called as a nipple. And this is the areola. So, during adolescence, the skin around the nipple get darkened. It get darkened during the adolescence period. And the nipple get prominent during the adolescence period. And it gets surrounded by this darkened region called as the areola. This areola having small openings, and these openings of a sebaceous gland. So listen carefully. This mammary gland is a modified sweat gland. In skin, there are two major glands. One is a sweat gland and another one is a sebaceous gland. Okay, the sweat gland secretes the sweat, okay, as its name. Okay, while the sebaceous gland, which secretes the sebum, it secretes the sebum. Sebum is the oily secretion. Okay, and this works as an, the oily secretions doesn't allow this areola to become a dry. Okay, so this is the important function. So it doesn't have any cracking. Okay, and get protected. So related with the areola. So what happens when the, as you know, the prolactin, as the prolactin gets synthesized or secreted by the anterior pituitary, okay, when mother consumes, the feedback is given to the anterior pituitary, and prolactin, when during the third trimester majorly, the growing fetus gives a stimulus to the anterior pituitary, and during that, the anterior pituitary starts to secrete prolactin. This prolactin, okay, tries to synthesize the secretion. Okay, this secretion is secreted into alveolus. It's secreted into the alveolus. So during the gestation period, the breast size of the female get increased as the gestation period progresses, right? It get increased because in the mammary gland, the alveoli get filled with the, yes, milk. Okay, so it starts to secrete some milk, and that is stored into the alveolus, right? Okay, afterwards what happened during during parturition, that means at the time of delivery, what happened? The growing fetus gives stimulus to the posterior pituitary. Mind it, first of all, when the growing fetus, the fetus is going into growing into the uterus or in the womb of mother, that time the stimulus is given to the anterior pituitary, to this part, and this anterior pituitary secretes the prolactin, and this prolactin start to secrete milk into the mammary gland. Okay, just a synthesis start. Okay, then what happened after parturition, after delivery, what happened? Okay, during delivery, as you know, the growing fetus, which is trying to come out, exerts a pressure on the cervix. During that, it gives a stimulus to this posterior pituitary, and during that, the posterior pituitary secretes large amount of oxytocin. Clear? This oxytocin is responsible for baby ejection, that means removal of baby from the uterus, that means it is responsible for delivery, ejection of baby, okay, as well as this oxytocin is also responsible for ejection of milk from the mammary gland. So a positive feedback is given to this mammary gland, and now when the oxytocin works on it, then this gland, especially the mammary gland, the first milk ejaculated, start to ejaculate or come out from the mammary gland after the baby birth only. When the baby birth happens or the baby delivered, at that time only the milk gets ejected out. Okay, and the first milk which is ejected from the mammary gland of the lady or any mammal is called as a colostrum. So this word is very important. What do you mean by colostrum? Okay, the first milk, colostrum means a first milk ejaculated from the mammary gland is called as a colostrum. So everyone is getting the point. What? The first milk which is ejected from the mammary gland is called as a colostrum. So this colostrum have very important content. Okay, what it contains? It basically contains the antibodies. So the first milk which is ejaculated from the mammary gland should not be wiped out. It must be given to the baby. Okay, it is slightly sticky and yellowish fluid. It is not a milk-like. It is quite sticky and yellowish fluid which is coming out from the nipple, okay? And that is called as a colostrum, and it must be given to the baby because it is the richest source of antibodies, which having less amount of fat, as already the female, the mother's milk, in case of human, having less fat content, it having very less fat content and having lactose. Basically, it having a lactose sugar, okay, which is digested by an enzyme called as a lactase, which is present in our body, okay. So, we can digest our mother's blood, okay. So, especially what happened, this oxytocin must be received on. There are some, especially there are specialized cells which are present around to this areola called as myoepithelial cells. Okay, it can be asked. Around to this areola, there are myoepithelial cells. The cell's name is a myoepithelial cells. Myoepithelial. As you know, the epithelial cells. Okay, pigment-like cells, epithelial cells, you know. Okay, but these cells are specialized one named as a myoepithelial, means having some muscle property, right? These are the myoepithelial cells. These are around to this alveolus, to this alveolus. So what happened when the oxytocin get released? What is the function of this myoepithelial cells? When the oxytocin get released, if suppose this is the oxytocin which is released into the blood, one goes to the uterus side and one goes to the mammary gland. Part of the oxytocin goes to the uterus and some part goes to, works on a breast. As we have studied in a previous video, that the uterine wall having oxytocin receptor. Likewise here in a breast, this myoepithelial cells, these myoepithelial cells which are present around this mammary alveolus are also having a receptor for oxytocin. So as this receptor receives the oxytocin, which exerts a pressure on this, a biochemical change occurs and the and the milk from the mammary alveolus goes into the lactiferous duct, and thus the milk is ejected out. And afterwards, as the sucking receptor is received by the mother, okay, the mother starts to secrete more and more and more prolactin hormone. Okay, as the prolactin get increased, she start lactating. Okay, and it continues up to 2 years also. Okay, the mother should feed her fetus or her the child, offspring, near about 2 years should be feed on mother's blood. Up to 2 years she can, but this is the, especially if mother still continue the feeding of the fetus over two years also, the mother also lactates. Why this is so? Because it is just a sucking action which stimulates to give stimulation to the anterior pituitary, and the anterior pituitary starts secreting prolactin. If she interrupts the feeding or breaks the feeding, at that time only the prolactin synthesis gets stopped, and then only the lactation stops. Otherwise, it will continue. Okay, by the sucking action of the baby, the prolactin gets synthesized. Okay, continue to synthesize. If she interrupts, then and then only the prolactin synthesis stops. Okay, so very interesting fact. related with the mother when the baby born, and then only the its food provision is given by the mother. Provision is done, okay, by naturally, by synthesis, by secreting the milk and ejaculating it, right? So related with you, you can see that it is a bonding between mother and the child. We know that this bond is so tight bond. This bond in between the mother and their children is always a strong bond. And that is because of the bonding hormone named as oxytocin. So the name given to the oxytocin is the bonding hormone. Why it is named as a bonding hormone? Because when we feel affinity about someone, during that also the oxytocin gets synthesized. But the quantity, as we comes in a contact with that person continuously, then and then only the oxytocin increases about that person, and especially the bond get established. And especially you see that the right from the birth time, mother loves her children's. Her children, because of she having large amount of oxytocin. Okay? So that is the reason, and so the oxytocin is called as another name. It is also called as a bonding hormone. Mind it and keep it in mind, the oxytocin. We feel affinity and love and affection about anyone, and that is because of this oxytocin. Okay, So this is all related with the mammary gland. Hope you understood. Okay. Then the next point from this topic is RCH, reproductive health. The next point is reproductive health. So, what do you mean by reproductive health? So, definition. So, the definition given by WHO is reproductive health means total well-being. Okay, it is a total well-being in all aspect. Total well-being in all aspects. Okay, it is a total well-being in all aspects of reproduction, its emotion of reproduction, its emotion, behavior, its emotion, then its behavioral and social aspect, behavioral and social aspects, and its social aspects along with the physical one, along with the physical one. Okay, so this definition of reproductive health is given by WHO, World Health Organization. So, according to WHO, the reproductive health means, especially reproductive health means healthy reproductive organ with a healthy functioning. Just simple definition. Healthy reproductive organ. Reproductive health means what? Healthy reproductive organs performing healthy or normal reproductive function. Just the definition. So, according to WHO, what it said, the reproductive health means total well-being in all aspects of reproduction. Total well-being in all aspects of reproduction. It's emotion. First point, it's emotion. Related with emotion. Then it's behavioral aspect. Then it's social aspect. and then physical aspect one. Okay. So related with emotion. As you know, this reproductive behavior is especially generated into our hypothalamus. Okay, it is generated into our hypothalamus and it is dealing with our emotions and according to behavior, okay, and social aspect also responsible and the physical one. Physical means must be the organ must be in well condition, okay, proper normal, performing normal functioning, right? So this is about the reproductive health. So in India, this practice was at very first time RCH, the name RCH, reproductive RCH. Okay, it is named as Reproductive and Child Health Care Program. Reproductive and Child Health Care Program. Okay. At national level, it is initiated in 1951 under the name of family planning. First of all, in India, it was started in 19 or introduced in 1951 at national level under the name of a family planning. Okay. Further on, it is named as RCH. Further, it is named as RCH. RCH means what? Reproductive and Child Health Care. Healthcare program. Reproductive and Child Health Care program. And that was initiated in 1951. 1951 it was initiated, and India is the only one Asiatic country which has started such a program at national level. At national level. And what was the prime goal of this RCH? Okay, what was the basic prime goal of this RCH? It works under so many, it having so many goals, and still now it is working. So related with the goals of RCH, we are dealing with the goals of RCH. So the first goal, to create awareness among the people about various aspects related with the reproduction. Okay, the first goal, goals of RCH. What are the goals of RCH? So first goal is a create awareness. Awareness among peoples about reproductive health. About reproductive health. Okay. It's awareness related with the reproductive health. Then the second one, to provide the facilities to people to understand and build up reproductive health. Okay, so the second one, to provide facilities. Provide facilities. Okay, to provide facilities related with, especially facilities to the people to understand and build up reproductive health. Okay, to build facilities to understand and build up reproductive health. So this is the second goal. Okay. Then the next one, to provide support. It provides support for building up reproductive healthy society. To provide support to provide support to build reproductively healthy society.
Okay.
Then the another one, to bring out the changes related with the issues, like to bring out the changes especially related with the issues related with, first one is inducing total infertility rate.
Okay, infertility rate.
Okay. Especially the first one is reducing the total infertility rate. To reduce the infertility rate, the first one. Awareness, as well as the first one is the critical health indications ke upar ye kaam karega. To first kya rahega usme? Reduce the infertility rate. Then the next one will be the reduces the infant mortality.
Infant mortality.
Okay, further on, the next will be a maternal mortality.
Maternal mortality.
So, to create awareness, especially it works on, these are the major issues. These are the major issues and on which we have to work a lot. Nowadays, as you know, the problems of infertility increases. Okay, so to reduce the rate of infertility, then after birth, the still baby born, or sometimes after the baby birth, the baby kid died because of so many factors. So we have to reduce it also. Then the further on, because of so many factors which are also affecting the delivered lady, and she may die. Okay, to reduce the maternal mortality, it is also one of the serious issue on which we have to work. On this, we have to work. So these are the main four goals in front of RCH. Okay, these are the major role in front of goals in front of RCH. So, what are the programs run by the government to fulfill or to complete this goal or to achieve this goal? What are the programs run by our government? Okay, so our government is playing a very important role for the child health as well as the pregnant lady health. Okay, so related with the how we achieve the goals of RCH. Now the next point, these are our goals, and now how we will achieve the goals of RCH. As you know, in our areas there are the ASHA workers. These ASHA workers are especially dealing with this RCH program. Okay. How to achieve goals? How to achieve goals? Goals of RCH. How we will achieve these goals? Okay. So, what are the programs runs under the RCH? So, the first one, how we will achieve? By introduction of sex education in our school. Introduction of sex education in schools. Okay, this is the first one, how we will achieve. As you know, introduction of sex education into the school, it is very important one, because we are creating awareness about reproductive health. We are creating awareness about reproductive health. As you know, nowadays also we are also creating awareness about corona and its prevention. Okay, preventive measures, how we will avoid it. Likewise, Okay, the first one is by introduction of sex education into the school. The first one is a safe and hygienic sexual practices. Introduction about or awareness about safe and hygienic sexual practices. First about, the first one is the education about sex organs. Then next one is the changes during adolescence. Adolescence, a very important period in our life, is the adolescence must be treated properly. Okay, this education is also given by the family, also must be given into the family also. By basically the family is also playing a very important role by giving this, but very liable is the school one. So we are introducing it into the syllabus. Okay, so changes during adolescence, what are the changes occurs in our adolescence period? Then the next one, changes as well as what are the common problems during adolescence. Common problems as well as hormonal changes during this period. Okay, we have studied secondary sexual characteristic, right? That come under this part. Okay, changes during adolescence. What are the changes occurs in our body? Okay, this comes under this, changes during adolescence, and what are the common problems during adolescence? Then hormonal changes during adolescence, and because of this hormonal changes, the physical or body appearance get changed. That must be known by the students which are at that age. Then the next one, another one is the knowledge about, must be having a knowledge about sexually transmitted diseases and AIDS. Awareness about this sexually transmitted diseases, as well as AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, uncontrolled or enormous, especially without court protection, if it happened, it causes such a diseases. Okay, this must be the adult or teenagers must aware about this sexually transmitted diseases so they can protect themselves from such a transmissions. Okay, so this is the first one, how we will achieve the goal of RCH by educating, by giving, and by introducing the sex education in our school syllabus. Okay, then the next one, use of audiovisual media. Second one, use of audio visual and printed material. Okay, so use of audio visual printed media. So how, as you know, awareness related with the reproduction is generated by giving audio visual videos can be shown to the youngsters or teenagers to spread a knowledge related with the reproductive health. Okay, how the hygiene must be kept during the periods. Okay, especially during the menstrual cycle, how the female will take care of her genital organs, or how to wash the genital organs with gentle sanitizer change the sanitary napkins or pads after use of 4 hours, you should change the sanitary napkins. Okay, all that, and they practice that that in their day-to-day life. Okay, and they use such a one of the very important important aspect. If we see that the awareness is generated by the media is playing very important role to spreading the awareness related with the reproductive health, that means use of contraceptive devices also, like Saheli, Maladi, as well as the use of condoms, okay, cervical caps, related with the family planning operations, okay. About that, the videos are also there. Even the one of the movie you have seen might be that is a Padman, which is related with awareness. So especially the audio visual and the printed media is also playing an important role. Okay, so the adult person or the teenagers may follow that and use like that. Okay, so proper practices are done by such a teenagers to create a awareness related with the reproduction. Okay, then the next one is the educate the younger generation. The next one is a educate the younger generation. Okay, so by educating the younger generation related with the birth control measures, then prenatal, postnatal care, so younger generation must be educated related with the prenatal. They must having a knowledge about birth control devices. Okay, they must having a knowledge related with the birth control device. Okay, must having the knowledge related with the birth control. Then the next one is related with the prenatal and the postnatal care. Prenatal and postnatal care. To avoid mortality rate of a child as well as a mother. Okay, so especially educate the younger generation about use of proper contraceptive devices or birth control devices, contraceptive or birth control devices. Okay, as well as proper care should be taken when the lady is pregnant. That means a balanced diet must be given to her so that the baby will be healthy. The baby will, which is born, which must be healthy. As you know, आपको पता है कि जो pregnant lady रहती है उसको ज्यादा nutrients की आवश्यकता रहती है, क्योंकि उसका जो fetus अंदर grow हो रहा है, it is absorbing all the nutrients from the mother's blood. So required, she required large amount of calcium, proteins, okay, as well as gases also required, and that is especially fulfilled when she will take a balanced diet, which will give a proper birth to the baby. Okay, she will give a birth to the healthy baby. Then and then only. Okay, so prenatal care must be important. The pregnant lady should visit the health center properly. She must according to WHO norms, she must follow all the instructions during her, as well as proper checking during her pregnancy or gestation period. She must be diagnosed, okay, during this. If she is anemic, must be given by the to treat that anemia, she must be given an injections or tablet also, that comes under the prenatal care. If the mother is anemic, okay, the pregnant lady is anemic, it may causes a serious case इट इज सीरियस, ये बहुत सीरियस हो सकता है जब वो डिलीवर्ड होगी, क्योंकि उसमें लॉस ऑफ ब्लड होगा एंड पहले से वो अगर ज्यादा एनीमिक रहेगी तो ब्लड लॉस से वो और भी एनीमिक हो सकती है एंड द डेथ मे ऑकर्स. ओके, टू अवॉइड सच डेथ्स, ओके, कैजुअलिटीज, वी रिक्वायर टू गिव अ proper attention to the pregnant lady and on her diet also and whatever the medicines given to her for the proper growth of her fetus inside. So the next one is a postnatal care. As the baby parturate, okay, bachcha hone ke baad bhi bahut sare health issues lady mein ho sakte hain, jaise ki wo zyada din bleeding mein ja sakti hai, bleeding shows, ब्लीडिंग वो दिखा सकती है, अगर ज्यादा ब्लीडिंग होता है फिर भी वो एनीमिक हो सकती है. ओके, सो ओनली 10 टू 12 डेज ब्लीडिंग इज इट्स नॉर्मल, इफ इट कंटिन्यूस फॉर लॉन्ग एंड द हेवी क्लॉट्स गोज ऑन देन शुड बी एग्जामाइंड प्रॉपरली. ओके, टू अवॉइड द एनीमिया इन द डिलीवर्ड लेडी. ओके, एंड शी मस्ट बी गिविंग टू फुलफिल हर नीड, because the delivered lady having less calcium, less hemoglobin, so she must be given, and she is now lactating, she is now lactating and feeding her fetus, feeding her baby. If agar wo apne bacche ko doodh de rahi hai to usko zyada nutrients dene ki zarurat hai, so the diet after birth of the baby must be given to the delivered lady, so she will recover her deficiencies of calcium as well as hemoglobin. Okay, and the amount of milk must be normal, remains normal if she is properly given a balanced diet. Okay, so this is all related with the education, educate the younger peoples. Then the next one is awareness about what? So awareness about increased population, awareness about what? So we must be aware about increased population. And we must aware, as you know, our India is crossing, having near about 1.35 billion number of, or it's our population. Okay, so it's a huge one. So to aware about increased population as well as social evils like sexual abuse and crimes related with the sex. Awareness about sexual abuse and sexual crimes, sex crimes or sexual crimes. Should aware, and not only aware, but should we take a necessary step to prevent such a crimes as well as sex abuse. Okay, awareness about increased population, first point. Okay, as you know, India is the second most ranking position in a population, achieving a second most ranking position in a population, as you know. So increased population, very enormously increased, so must be use of birth control devices is must in India. Then sex abuse and sexual crimes. Okay, then the next one related with this, our government is also playing a very important step and legalized practices now and changing the acts also related with the sex crime nowadays. And that is related with the to take a, that is one of the necessary step to prevent the crimes, okay, or such evils. Then next one is the ban on amniocentesis for sex determination. Okay, the next one is a ban on amniocentesis. As you know, the amniocentesis is one of the technique which is used to detect out the genetic defects Okay, but it is misused for sex determination, and it now you know that it is legalized by the government. Especially those having such a history, they only go for amniocentesis. Okay, or any hazardous chemicals they have consumed, the pregnant lady has accidentally consumed, then and then only they can go for amniocentesis. It is legalized, right? So we can avoid it. And the next one is the awareness about child immunization program. Very important. Child immunization program. The governments are playing a very important role. Though we have a very large population still now, our government is distributing the vaccine in a free of cost. Okay, in a free of cost. See, whatever the BCG, Penta are given to the born babies, the children's, these vaccines are given to the children, they are totally free of cost. So this initiation is taken by our government, but we have to go to the government hospital to take such vaccines, right, which are in a pure form. We have to take vaccines from and from only the PSC centers, primary health centers. Okay, these are in a pure form. Especially, so awareness must be generated in a population for immunization of the children's. Okay, then the next one is by educating the couples to reduce mortality of newborn and the delivered lady. Okay, couples should be aware. Unko aware karna padega kis baare mein, especially to reduce the mortality of the newborn. How to take care of newborn baby? That means, as you know, advertisement में दिखाया जाता है कि बच्चों को नहाते कैसे, नहलाते कैसे, वो भी दिखाते हैं. क्यों? It is one of the practice of the baby care. Okay, it is one of the practice of the baby care. So we have to change their the huggies and all that after some hours also. Basically, we have to use a cotton clothes to clean it and use gentle sanitizers to clean their areas also. So this is all related with the RCH. Now we will stop here. Thank you.